Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. Thanks a lot to the Forward team for the invitation. I must say it's really hard to come here on stage to talk to you after listening to these two brilliant gentlemen talk about their sectors, but I will try to do my best to keep to be the bar very high. So today, we'd love to, in about 10 minutes, talk to you about three things. First of all, tell you a little bit more about the vision behind Uber. I hope many of you might have used Uber somewhere, either outside of Spain or hopefully here in Madrid as well, but tell you a bit more about what's the vision behind it. Specifically, tell you a bit more about the efforts we're doing to adjust our model and position Uber as a leading brand in the luxury tourism space. And finally, talk a bit about some of the examples of collaboration that we have worked on over the past years with the tourism sector towards that common goal of making, as we say, mobility better adapted to luxury tourism. So I'll jump straight into it. The vision behind Uber is actually quite simple. The task is obviously much more challenging. The idea is to go beyond the current mobility model based on private car ownership that we know is not only ineffective, but also not sustainable for the planet we live in, and migrate to a model that is based on mobility as a service. The idea that you don't have to own the means of transportation, that you can use them when you need them, as you need them. No? And the idea is pretty simple. You have in one app the combination of all the different mobility alternatives that you need to move around the city, be it a car with a driver, be it a micro-mobility service, a scooter, a bike, et cetera, public transit, you name it, all these mobility options combined in a smart way so that you can get from point A to point B in the most affordable and most effective way possible. Again, much more easier said than done. Now, with this vision, we've actually built the company into a pretty big organization. And as you can read here, we provide reliable and safe transportation for 16 million people a day. I joined, I was lucky enough to join in 2014 when the company was much smaller, and I must say it has been an incredible ride to get to where we are today. Having said that, I feel we're only scratching the surface. And when you look at the numbers, when you break down these numbers by case study, and you start looking at some of the most obvious case studies, going from the airport to whatever you need to get, business trips, et cetera, the penetration of Uber is getting to a decent level. However, as you go down the list, you can see that the penetration is significantly lower. And I definitely, as my colleagues here were saying, I see this as an opportunity, and I feel we're only seeing kind of the top of the iceberg, and there's a lot more work and a lot more potential ahead. Now, at the beginning, Uber was, I feel, quite a undifferentiated business. No? People would talk about hailing an Uber, and that was about it. Today, we want to make sure that we give the right experience and the right product to the right customer at the right time. And for that, we've borrowed the thinking and the segmentation in a way of the airline industry that I feel we have a lot to learn from. No? So you might have used UberX, which is our economy, the equivalent of what economy would be in an airline. You have a very interesting offering, which I'm kind of very proud here in Madrid, called Comfort and Uber One, which would be kind of the equivalent of premium economy. And of course, the big protagonist that I wanted to talk to you about today, Uber Black, which is our premium business first class service. No? So what do we mean when we talk about Uber Black? No? What's behind, why would you use Uber Black? What's this all about? No? And I feel there's many components here that I think make up that Black premium experience. For sure, the car is important, no? And the model of the car is for sure important, and the expectation there is very high, so you would have the typical Mercedes and so forth. Now, what we have learned at Uber is that actually what correlates more with the quality perceived by the rider, but by the person taking the experience, is actually not the car, but the driver. And I don't think that's a surprise. No? This is why in Uber Black, you would only have our utmost top drivers that have had a significant experience with us and have proven trip after trip that they are actually truly going to deliver a five-star experience. So those drivers alone would be the ones that you would find there. Of course, because we have all this experience about all these trips that have happened that you might have taken with us, we want to make sure that all your preferences are taken into account. So anything from the AC, the music you like, whether you want to engage in a friendly conversation or not, all of these things are preferences that you can customize into the app and make sure that they're taken into account by the driver from the get-go. And one thing that seems pretty obvious but was not that obvious for us was the ability to actually book a trip in advance. Uber, in general, has worked as an on-demand platform. You would push a button and get a car immediately, but we all know people want to make sure that they are going to have a car no matter what. So within Uber Black, for the first time in our kind of 10-year history, you will be able to book a trip in advance and make sure that when you get to the Madrid airport, your top driver and your Mercedes is going to be there waiting for you. And obviously, the experience doesn't finish when you end the trip. Sometimes, even despite all our best efforts, things happen. No? You might forget an item in the car. There's so many things that unfortunately can go wrong in life. No? This is why we also embed our premium 24/7 customer support to make sure that your experience is also equally satisfying even beyond the trip. So all that being said, we're actually very lucky to see that looking at the data for Madrid, luxury transportation is actually on the rise and has increased by more than 70% over the last 2 years. No? So definitely very encouraging early signs, but as we saw in the chart before, definitely a lot of room to grow, and I feel we still have a long way again ahead in positioning Uber as a top brand in this space and making sure that we as Uber are providing the type of experience that your customers need in terms of mobility. No? Now, when we talk about Uber, probably most of you have used us as a customer. How many of you, if you may raise your hand, have used Uber for their private mobility needs? Do you mind raising their hands? Great, thanks. And how many of you have actually used it for business reasons? That's not bad, that's encouraging. Actually, I feel the business segment has been a bit a pending subject for Uber, but I'm very confident that we're now on the right spot to truly deliver on this same experience that we've created for the B2C segment, also for B2B. And make sure that we actually offer a truly magical Uber experience across the entire, let's say, roster of needs that as a business you might have. The most obvious ones would be mobility for your employees. And I feel this is particularly important now as companies are struggling to get their employees back to the office. No? But thinking about your sectors in particular, I feel there are other products that are incredibly interesting. No? Think about a hotel that might want to offer a convenient transportation option on Uber Black to the clients in the hotel and do that from a central panel in the hotel and build that directly to the room or offer it as a courtesy trip. Think about restaurants and so forth. Think about airlines that would want to offer that service to the customers and make sure that they offer the end-to-end experience door-to-door. The possibilities here are endless, not only on the mobility side, but also on the delivery side. Uber Eats obviously has a very powerful U4B offering, corporate offering as well, and make sure that not only you help employees go back to the office, but entice them also with a fantastic meal delivered to their offices. I could be speaking here for an hour on our U4B offerings, but time is short, so if you have any questions, our colleagues from the U4B team here are here to assist you on any questions you might have. To finish, I'd just like to very, very quickly show you two very simple examples of the types of collaboration that we have explored over the last couple of months with the tourism industry as a whole, and that hopefully might help as a reflection on the type of things that we could be doing together in the coming years, again, to elevate this luxury experience in mobility as well. The first one is one that was announced a few months back, coming from the US, but now applicable globally, with Marriott. As you can read, very simple but very powerful. Take a trip, and with every trip that you take on Uber, you will accumulate miles on your Bonvoy loyalty program with Marriott. Huge results. I don't want to walk you through the specific numbers now, but again, as I mentioned, great traction so far, and extremely proud to be working with such a leading brand like Marriott. And then here in Europe, more recently, a similar collaboration with Miles & More, where again, similarly, whenever you travel with Uber, you would accumulate miles on your Miles & More account. Again, these are just two examples. I think the possibilities are endless, and we're at Uber extremely excited for the years ahead. To finish, and I'll just take one more minute, I want to show you one of the projects that we're more excited about at Uber that is might seem quite futuristic, but could be a reality in cities like Madrid in not such a long time. And hopefully next year or in a couple of years, we'll all be able to come to Madrid and come to Forward using this very out-of-the-box mobility option, which we call vertical takeoff and landing, VTOL. I'm sure many of you might have heard. And the video will show you a bit the end-to-end customer experience that we could be offering to our guests, hopefully very soon. As you can see, this is a commuting use case. Our protagonist just came out of work, and she will request Uber Air from her app. The app will direct her to the closest Uber Air port. She will take the elevator, which will already indicate the floor that she needs to go to. The boarding pass would be on her app. And using this vehicle, which is fully electric and will be fully autonomous very soon, she will be able to do a trip that on Uber, on a regular Uber car, might take 45 minutes to an hour. Think about commuting cases in cities like Mexico City, Rio de Janeiro, Abu Dhabi, Dubai, LA, downtown to the suburbs in just shy of 15 minutes. And over time, hopefully at a price that is also not that expensive. Helicopters, funny enough, have a huge problem, which is noise. Many of you might know, and this is one of the things that is not an issue with vertical takeoff and landing, which we hope will be able to help cities embrace this technology in a more positive way. So that's all on our side. It was a pleasure to be with you, and looking forward to the next chapters on this exciting sector. Thanks a lot.